Razabani for IFL TV, proudly sponsored by Everlast. I'm delighted to have with me, making his professional debut today, and IFL TV debut, Mr. Niall Brown. Niall, how are we doing?
I'm good, thank you. Yeah, I'm good.
Look, before we come up and talk about the fight itself, I know you've been itching. I've spoken to Pat about making your professional debut, and it's dragged and dragged, and you're hoping you're getting out next month, and then the government says, sorry, you can't. But how frustrating has that period been?
It has been quite frustrating, like you said, because it's just like you get to that point and then you think, oh, I've only got a month, and then they push it back again. But just be persistent, and to be honest, give me more time to train, so there's a positive come out of it.
Did you manage to kind of keep yourself motivated in your mindset on the goal of, I want to make my debut eventually?
Yeah, of course. Because like I said, I also want to get better every day, and the place you get better is in the gym, so... Without no fights, you've only got training to do and to get better. So,
just before you fought, CJ Challenger was out, and I said to him, that was probably the loudest cheer of the night. But I forgot that Niall Brown was going to walk out, and the crowd were roaring. But goosebumps as you're walking in?
Yeah, it was good, because like, I've not fought for like nearly 6 years and a half, and having that feeling. So yeah, it was good. Everyone came out to support me, and it's good, man. I appreciate it.
Sometimes, you know, when the crowd's for you in such high volume, you just want to go in there and give the fans a knockout. But did you want to get more rounds in, or if the knockout came, it came?
Yeah, if it comes, it comes. Like, you don't get paid overtime, so I'm not going to stay in there if I don't need to. I'm not going to stay in there for, do you know what I mean? I think anything can happen, so the quicker it's over, the better, really. But I prepared for more than four rounds.
I think you caught him with an uppercut in the second knockdown. He went down, and I thought he wasn't going to get up. But did you think that was it? It was done?
Yeah, I thought he weren't getting up. I think it was like an uppercut and a hook, and I thought he's not getting up, but fair play to him. Yeah.
And then a grueling body shot to finish him off. Something you've been working on?
Yeah, we work on every shot, to be honest. So, yeah, it's a good shot because I've been working on it. It's good to get the result.
How's the relationship building with Pat now? I know, obviously, he's got a number of fighters. He's been in the industry for decades now, so great experience, but how's that relationship and chemistry?
It's good, you know, because he's a perfectionist, and I like that, because I am a bit myself, so it's only going to bring the best out of me. Yeah, and it's good to see him happy that I've done what he wanted to do.
Talk about the bet.
Oh yeah, I've got a bet with him. He said if you stop him with 500 to the body, I'll give you 500 quid, and then Zelva topped it with 250, so I'm 750 up.
750, not too bad. Now the middleweight division's thriving in the UK. It's always kind of been thriving in the UK, but what kind of are your ambitions? Do you want to just slowly trickle, get those learning fights, get to 10, 12, 15, 0? We've seen Josh Taylor become undisputed in 18. We've seen Lawrence Okolie become world champion, I think 15, 16 fights. Yeah. What's your ambition? What's your route and road?
I just want to be the best I can be. And whatever comes with that, I think titles will come with that. But like I said, I'm just focusing on myself at the minute. Yeah.
Got a date in mind when you're out next?
I'm not too sure, but hopefully like September maybe.
Sorry. Manchester City and England international, Mr. Phil Foden was out here supporting you today. Talk about your relationship with Phil.
Yeah, I've known Phil since we were kids, really. We grew up in the same like area. So I'm glad that he's come. It's the first fight he's been to all these years, because he's always had training, and vice versa, when I want to go up and watch footy, I've got training, so it's good that he could come and support me. I appreciate it. Yeah. And I think everyone else loved it, to be honest. Getting pictures and whatnot.
Any words of advice did he give you?
Just keep doing what I'm doing. Keep just trying to be the best you can be, which is good, because he's like a really high level athlete, and that's where I'm looking to be.
Absolutely. Well, now, congratulations once again. Before I end, where can we catch you for the IFL viewers on your social media platform? I know it's the first time we've got you on the channel. It won't be the last, but in terms of your social media platforms, what are they?
Mainly Instagram, to be honest, which is Brown_Niall. That's it, really. Facebook, Niall Brown. Yeah.
Well, we'll certainly follow the journey, and hopefully we'll catch up with you very, very soon. Niall Brown, IFL TV, thank you very much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.